we are making a second episode in the same week because, like I said, Wendy is going to move and she's more or less in the beginning to really actually move. So just in case you don't have time because you're moving, we have already pre-calculated an episode for our viewers. So welcome back. And this is going to be an exciting episode. I'm not going to tell you why. Okay, we're going to lightning. So no, this is not Frankenstein or Dracula. This is lightning, is electricity. It's going to be electrifying like Saturday Night Fever. We've got the lightning card. The bolt of lightning is a symbol of power and destruction. The ancient myths that say that Romans, Greeks, and other early civilizations worshipped lightning came from belief in the spirit world. A handful of gods relied on the power of lightning bolt to threaten, scare, or punish the mortals on earth. One of the most powerful of Greek gods was Zeus, and his weapon of choice was the lightning bolt. The lightning bolt also has a deep biblical link to Lucifer. Typically, the symbolic meaning of lightning deals with instant and divine intervention. Lightning is a major message from a higher source, a message from the observer to wake up and pay attention to his or her surroundings. When this card is drawn, it should be taken as a warning to do just that. Pay close attention to what creative or destructive forces are at work in your life, and then handle to them accordingly. If you choose to ignore a warning, lightning may very well strike. The crystal gem is opal. Opals were once known as sirenia, or thunderstones. The brilliant play of color within the precious opal flashes like lightning across the sky. Meditate on opal for divine inspiration and enhanced perception. Incantation. I've just been warned to be alert in order to remain alert. Show me what I need to see and let love and light develop me.
Ja, beautiful card. Ja, deze kaart waarschuwt eigenlijk dat je op moet passen en alert moet zijn wat er om je heen gebeurt.
This card also is a warning, according to Wendy, that don't just focus on what is in front of you, but focus on what is happening around you.
Ja, ook wat er om je heen gebeurt, handel daar ook naar. De bevindingen die je binnenkrijgt, of die je ziet of hoort, of wat voor manier dan ook binnenkrijgt, ga ermee aan de slag.
Wendy says, if you see something happening, or if you feel something, if you're intuitive, act upon it. Don't just sit around, but act upon it and do something with it.
Ja, nou ja, denk goed om jezelf daar ook daarin en bescherm jezelf. En ga je de verkeerde weg in, dan heeft het wel consequenties, geeft het aan.
Think of yourself, protect yourself, but if you go on the wrong path, then it has consequences. So the consequences will be very severe.
Ja, ook, ze zeggen niks, een gewaarschuwd mens stelt voor twee. Hè, dat zeggen wij dan in Nederland in de volksmond. Dus, maar het gaat met deze kaart wel op.
We don't have a saying, not for nothing, in Holland, but also in England, forewarned is forearmed.
Nou, klopt. En ik zeg altijd van, met deze kaart van doe ermee wat je wil, maar mensen maken hun eigen keuzes. Maar wees wel bewust van welke keuzes je maakt en wat je doet. Welke pad ga jij bewandelen in het leven?
This card is also be conscious of what choices you are making. Take also... realize that there are consequences in the choices that you make, and protect yourself. And remember, That's what, I'm saying this as well, Wendy. A lot of people don't dare to make a choice because they are scared of the consequences.
Ja, klopt. Ja, dat is de kaart.
That is the card. Now we're going to the next card. Something so simple, but yet so very powerful. All the cards that can bring out beautiful messages like this.
Yeah.
Then we have the magic candles. The dancing flame of a candle represents the element of fire and has been used as witches' tool for centuries. Candles can absorb your personal energy and then release that energy as they burn. Candle magic is a simple and very powerful form of sympathetic magic and has been in existence for many centuries. The body of candle is made up from the elements of earth, air and water. To make it complete, you need fire and spirit. Fire is easy and spirit can be represented by the wick of the candle, and the wick is where the potential of the candle lies. We all start our experience with candle magic at an early age. With a birthday cake, we were told to close our eyes, make a wish, and blow out the candles. And while together, today may not be your birthday, you have been granted a wish to make. Light and candle, concentrate on what you want and let the flame of your intent burn. Anything is possible right now, if you want it badly enough. The crystal gemstone is garnet. Red garnets have warm, fiery energy that fuels our passion and desires, and their crystal structure helps to anchor our needs and wants into the physical plane. They are perfect tools for all kinds of manifestations. Work with garnet to ground and focus your magical work. The incantation of affirmation: with this flame that burns so bright, I wish I may, I wish I might. I use this fire to inspire, so bring to me what I desire.
Beautiful card. Deze kaart houdt in principe in, hè, kaarsen sowieso zijn heel erg belangrijk voor de hekserij, hè, voor het gebruiken voor rituelen.
The card is very, very important because the candles are very important. That is normal. That is, you know, it is, you use it in the witchcraft, also for incantations or healings or spells.
Klopt. En het is een, je kan er rituelen mee doen, maar ook in contact te komen met je hogere, je eigen ik.
You can use it for rituals or get in contact with your higher self.
Ja, nou, en ook alles wat belangrijk is voor jou. Dus ook de goden, de engelen, hè, waar jij voor staat, zeg maar. Maar ik gebruik het dan voor, hè, de goden die staan voor de hekserij.
Wendy uses this. You might have other representations or meaning for the candles, but she says it stands for her, it stands for the gods. I think, because there's three candles there, it's like the Holy Trinity.
Yeah.
Heaven, earth and the humans, for example.
Ja, klopt. Ja, onder andere. Ja. Het is ook nou, het contact maken met alle elementen, hè, eigenlijk. De elementen, het is een onderdeel van een element, zo noem ik dat. Want it's vuur is bij nodig.
Elements like earth, fire, water and air.
Ja, en het kan je zoveel meer geven. En je contact maken met het hogere, met overleden personen. Alles wat er om je heen gebeurt, wensen mag je doen. Ja, echt vooral ook wensen, maar ook uitspreken wat je wil, hè?
Okay, this helps you to get into the sphere of making contact with your higher self, with people that have passed over, and also with, you know, speak what you mean and say what you mean and do what you say, and also to make your wishes coming true or your manifestations, visualizations. Okay.
Maar ook een kaars brandt als het ware op een gegeven moment als je je wens uitspreekt op het moment als de kaars brandt. En uitblazen, laat het maar meegaan met het universum.
That's a nice one. Wendy also says, if you light a candle and you have put your manifestation, visualization or your wish or goal into the air, outspoken it out to the air, to the universe, then blow the candle out and let it go with the flow.
Ja, en het is ook sowieso, het helpt ook mee voor een groot succes. Hè? Het, je zal het beleven, ervaren en voelen. En dat ja.
Yeah, you will experience, sorry about that, you will experience success. And you can see it, you can feel it and you can smell it.
Ja, ja, klopt.
I mean.
Okay, the last card. Hi, Ivan. I heard him. I love him. Okay. And the next card, we have the magic wand.
Yes.
So I hope you can see this. And I know after this, something special is going to be done. Okay. Magic wand. It is said that the oldest, most famous magician tools is the magic wand. Some consider it. Sorry, hold on. Some consider it to be a symbol of divine wisdom. Others see it as a porthole, a port table, portable, handy version of a broom. Wands and references to wands can be found throughout history and in all cultures. The preferred method of crafting a wand is from a fallen tree branch rather than cutting from a live tree. The wood from which the wand is made determines its purpose. For example, apple wood is good for divine. Ebony is favored for defensive magic, and oak is excellent for protection, defense, prosperity, and sacrifice. All magic wands found throughout history are said to be able to transmit energy to anything and anything and anywhere. It is a focus point of your energy to channel magic into the specific place of a specific purpose. By receiving this card in a reading, you are given the gift of being able to achieve what has been eluding you for some time, or the ability to make whatever changes in your life that needs to be made. Wands are associated with yang energy, that's the masculine according to me, the power of great change. Use your wand for focus, your energy, and make it happen. The crystal gemstone is scepter crystal. Scepters form when one crystal caps the termination of another, resembling a crystal wand. They are masters at moving energy and directing focus. Work with a scepter crystal whenever you need to focus your intent to create change. The incantation or the affirmation is a magical tool in my hand. The future will be very grand. Grand, sorry. If it's the same thing. Grand, that's the English language. It's like plastic and plastic. I'll start again. Magic tool in my hand. The future will be grand. If you help me wave away the useless ways of yesterday, change is necessary. Change is good. I now embrace it as I should.
Beautiful cards. Mooi. Nee, deze kaart staat voor transformeren van energie en situaties in je leven.
This card stands for, or the wand stands for, transformations in situations and issues in your life.
En veranderen wat gebeuren moet.
And to change what needs to be changed. And what ja. has to be done.
Positief veranderen. En dat gaat dan ook wel lukken, zeg maar. Het positieve veranderen wat op je pad komt, gaat veranderen.
To change the negative in the positive. And whatever comes onto your path, that it will change to positivity.
Ja, klopt. En ook wees krachtig in je eigen ik. Straal dat uit en niks is onmogelijk.
Stand in your strength and also be the beacon or shine this out towards the outside world, family and friends. You will be the magnet and you'll be powerful.
Klopt. En Ivan, geven. Transformeer en creëer en streef naar je wensen. Dat is gewoon heel belangrijk met deze kaart. Gewoon streef je wensen uit. Dus met die magic wand, hè, de toverstok, zeg maar. Door iets krachtig kun je het transformeren. Laat het maar gaan.
Use the wand to direct or manifest what you wish. It means transformation. And sorry, Wendy, I lost it there.
Oh, sorry. Soms dan zeg ik iets. Of nou, transformeer en streef je wensen na, creëert en laat het gaan.
Strive to follow your wishes. That's what I forgot. Sorry, guys, I forgot that. So the wand is also point at what you want and also symbolically it says or means strive after what you wish for and what you want, your goals, so that they can come true.
Ja, klopt. Dat is deze kaart. Een hele mooie kaart.
And she loves this card as well. But Wendy's got, and I asked her, what have you got a magic wand? And she came with this story. Over to you, Wendy.
Okay, nou, ik ga zelf een toverstok. Toverstaf ga ik zelf maken. En deze toverstaf of stok ga ik maken van.
Wendy is says, I'm going to make my own wand. She's going to tell you. And I'll just translate it for the English speaking people.
Ja. Yeah. Dit is een tak als het ware van de lijsterbesboom.
Deze?
This is a branch. And the sun is coming in as well. He's a cutie though. He's so helpful. It just goes to show what type of mother she is. She's lovely. Because she's taught the kids to help others and they are really lovely children. Brandy says, this branch, that's my staff. It's a long one. And this is wood from a rowan berry tree, or also known as the mountain ash tree.
Ja, klopt. Dit is dan een wat kortere variant. Daar ga ik een toverstaf van maken. Of een magic wand. En ik heb hier, dus een hele lange. Een hele lange. Daar ga ik echt een looptoverstaf mee maken. Even stil.
She's going to make a walking staff of the longer one.
Ja, dan ga ik verschillende maken. Dus sowieso de toverstokje als het ware.
Magic wand.
Ja.
If you stay with us, then you will see the finished product after the summer. Because she's going to have a busy period because she's going to move home and then she will have time because the children will be home as well, but she'll have more time to make her wand and staff. So we will hopefully be back in the autumn after the summer holidays.
Yeah.
But we've still got a lot of cards, around 15 cards to discuss. So we have another 3 or 4 episodes. And I love doing this series and these episodes with Wendy, collaborating with Wendy. So if you like this series, then please follow us and let us know beneath the video whether you want this series to continue. And I know I'm going to get another witch's deck. That's going to be the Shadowlands, and I'm still waiting for them.
Yeah.
Okay, and we might actually, we will also be seeing, once Wendy's moved, what a witch's altar looks like. We will also see what a spell is, and other sort of spell, because Wendy has put it all into boxes. So we are going to see more in the autumn than before the summer holidays. We are just whetting your appetite.
Ja. Ja, ik heb er heel veel zin in en dan kan ik alles laten zien wat ik heb, zeg maar. En dat kan nu niet.
She's really looking forward to it. She really wants to do that, but she can't do that because everything is packed in.
Ja, ja, ja.
Thank you. Well, you know where I am if you need a helping hand for anything. So take care, stay safe and be blessed.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you for collaborating and working with me. Love you. Ciao, ciao.
You too. Bye-bye.